Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'll be showing you how to produce fondant icing. If you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, please do that. We have glucose here, we have CMC, we have gelatine, and we have navy blue color for the icing, and then we have our icing sugar 500 grams, and our bowl with sieve. You must sieve your icing sugar in because of particles that do come with it, and there again, so it can dissolve, because there are sometimes the icing sugar gets caked, so you have to always sieve it so it will be very free and dusty when you're mixing. Then this is plates for the gelatine to be mixed, then pots to use and dissolve it. You watch out to see how it's being produced. This plate and spoon, you measure 2 tablespoons of the gelatine and 8 tablespoons of water. In this tablespoons of water, you can also use 4 tablespoons of water depending on how you want it. We'll measure this gelatine 2 tablespoons and 8 tablespoons of water. You can also use 4 tablespoons of water. But before I do that, first of all, what I'll do is to put my pot first on fire with water. I won't allow it to boil, to just heat a little. Then I will measure my gelatine with my water, then put it. But before then, I'll have to sieve my icing sugar first in the bowl, put my CMC, then make sure it's set before dissolving the gelatine. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you see how smooth the icing sugar is. It's not rough, it's very smooth at hand. So this is how it's supposed to be once you sieve your icing sugar. If you don't sieve it, will be very rough.
I'll put 8 tablespoons of water. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So you see what it looks like. This is how it will be. You don't allow the water to get hot. So once the thing dissolves a little, what you have to add next is your glycerin. 1/8 tablespoon. No, you put your glucose first, 2 tablespoons. Then you put your glycerin, 1/8 TSP. Okay, so you add your CMC, 1/2 tablespoon of CMC, then you mix. You'll be pouring the liquid gradually to mix. Just continue mixing and mixing till you get the shape, or till it gets round. But you have to continue pouring the liquid anyways and continue mixing. You have to mix it very fast, but if not, it will get strong and you'll not be able to get what you want. Now you have to continue kneading it till you get what you want. If it's very strong, you have to, I'm using corn flour here because when after mixing it was very soft, so I had to use corn flour to make it a bit thick, for it to be a bit strong. Then if it's too strong, you have to use Crisco or vegetable oil. It's called Crisco or vegetable oil. To apply, you can apply it on the surface of your table, then continue kneading your work. you have to knead it very well for it to be a bit stretchy. You can see how stressful this work is. That's why fat is running away from me because of this kind of thing. Smoothen it very well. Use it to smoothen the body too, so it will lap well. And then just smoothen it very well. Then when you're done, clean your board. And yes, I know I've not used my blue color, but I'll still use it, although it's not in this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this art video, give us a thumbs up. And if you've not subscribed to this channel before, please subscribe to it. We need your subscription over here. Share to your loved one, share to people, and like the video. Thank you.